Welcome back. In today's video, I'll be showing you how to fix sound not working on your Samsung phone. Within the methods, if you can't seem to find the page I'm on, you should be able to get there by using the search function at the top of the settings. Let's get into them. We'll start with some obvious fixes, so feel free to skip ahead a little if you've tried these. First, use the volume buttons on your device to see if this increases the sound. You might want to have a video or some music ready to play to test the sound on your device as we move through the methods. Next, if the sound isn't working on your headphones or earphones, I'd recommend testing them on another device if you can, to see if they work there. If they don't, they might be broken. If you have a Bluetooth device, try unpairing it in the Bluetooth settings, and then pair it again. Alternatively, if it's the speakers on your device that aren't working, try connecting some headphones or earphones, and if the sound now works, your speakers may need repairing. Check your speakers though now, as there could be dust, debris, or even water blocking them and causing them to not work or not work properly. If you think there's dust or debris blocking the speakers, then you can try gently cleaning them. Also check that your case is not blocking the speaker. Of course, there's a chance that the problem is a physical fault with the device or speakers, so if none of the methods work, you might want to check with your manufacturer or your warranty for repair options. Next, try turning off Bluetooth either in the quick access panel by swiping down from the top and then by using the button, or in the connection settings. This might fix it if your device is connected to a Bluetooth speaker, preventing the sound from being played out the device's own speakers. We'll now try some more volume settings. Use the volume buttons again to increase the volume, and when the volume slider appears on the screen, see if you can tap on the three dots icon to view all the volume sliders. Your device will have separate volume control for calls, alarms, and media. Make sure that each of these are turned up. If you cannot adjust the volume, or you think that Do Not Disturb is affecting the volume, then open the Settings app and look for the Do Not Disturb option. This can be found within the Notification Settings page. Make sure this is turned off, or customize the settings to allow the sounds you want, and now try adjusting the volume. We can also check the volume within the settings. Tap on the option called Sounds and Vibration, and check that Mute is not turned on here, and you can check each level is turned up again in the Volume section. Now would be a good time to restart your device if you haven't already, as this could refresh some of the settings to fix the problem. Next, we can check the sound balance. Open the settings app again, and this time, scroll down and tap on Accessibility. Now choose the option called Hearing Enhancements. Look for the sound balance option here, and make sure that this is central. If the issue only appears in certain apps, you could either check within the app's own settings, or research online the sound problem with your app, as there's probably some better and more specific solutions. You could also check for One UI or Android updates in the settings, as this has a chance at fixing the problem if it was caused by a bug of the operating system. The final method should only be a last resort, and it's not guaranteed to fix it. It is to factory reset your device. You'll need to make sure everything is backed up before doing so, but this can be done in the Reset section of the settings. Unfortunately, those are all of the methods I have. As always, I'll keep the description updated with any new solutions I find, and if any of you find a fix in the future, then it would be great if you could return to the video and post it in the comments to help others. Click the card on screen now to watch a video of mine showing you 10 easy ways to speed up your Samsung device. If you have any questions, then let me know in the comments below, and if you did find today's video helpful, remember to leave a like and feel free to subscribe for more tips in the future. Be sure to stick around to see some of my other videos that you might be interested in. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you in another video.